I'm at the barn, so I'm just going to do a bit of a vlog for you guys if my phone doesn't die. I just finished riding 10 horses at work, so I'm really tired. So I might just do groundwork today with the boys. I longlined Archie the other day, and he was pretty good, so we're probably going to try to do that again. And yeah, it's really peaceful. There's no one here. It's nice out, but it's pretty cold. It's supposed to snow again this weekend, so I'm hoping to just kind of film a vlog for you guys to post when I can't really do anything. Holy geese, is this like some sort of party? Geese are awful creatures. Canadian geese are so mean. Canadians are supposed to be nice. These guys are dicks.
Milo's wondering why he's not coming. But that's what happens when you're not at the gate first, buddy. You can't leave them together because they need better manners, and they take advantage of me now that they've realized I can't control two horses well with a broken hand.
The goal is to get Archie better at cross tying because he always likes to paw and move around like this. Racehorse problems. But yeah, so we've just been practicing tying for longer periods of time, which he does not like.
We're wearing a surcingle and we're very, very impatient,
as always. This is the most annoying thing about racehorses off the track, in my opinion, if they're not good at tying, which a lot of them aren't, even if they're used to tying, because they get impatient.
So we're heading to the arena to do some longlining and lunging.
Archie, get up here. Why are you doing that? He's so slow for a racehorse. My goodness.
But yeah, so get up here. We're heading to the arena and we're going to do some longlining and lunging. Or we're going to attempt to do some longlining. And we're going to do some lunging. We had issues to the right last time, so we'll see how that goes. I'll try to film some. We'll see how that goes too.
I didn't really film much of our session until now because it was all stop and go because he was insistent that he couldn't lunge and that he forgot, and then when he remembered he could only lunge at the canter and kept coming in towards me with his shoulder, which is obviously not safe and was not okay. So I'm just filming now because this is after we've had like half an hour of me insisting that he does in fact know how to lunge. And apparently he's figured it out now, so props to Archie. But this is like what it's like having a baby. They'll go forward one day and he's doing something way harder, which is long lining. And then today he couldn't even lunge. And we had to argue and he had to work way harder than I had planned for him because he needed to finish on a good note. And now you can see he's listening to me
and being a good boy
and trotting a whole circle. Good boy. So he's pretty much done now. I just wanted to show you guys that he can lunge. No long lining today because apparently his baby brain can't handle it today.
Anyways, yeah. I won't be posting any of the footage when he is being bad because he kept running out of the frame since I had my camera on the fence and he'd run and go buck. So you can't see him for most of it anyways, and I was cursing at him a lot. Because that's what I do when horses are being frustrating. And people would say I'm being mean and verbally abusive to my horse, which is silly because he doesn't know what I'm saying. But yeah, so we figured it out and he finished on a good note, which is good. So hopefully next time we lunge, he'll start off better in the first place because he needs to realize he works way harder when he's not good.
Anyways, I was hoping he'd roll because he wanted to roll in his surcingle. And he tried to go down and roll in the surcingle in that corner there, but apparently now that he's sweaty and should roll, he doesn't want to. He always picks the worst places to roll. Gotta watch that he doesn't roll all the way over and cast himself. Oh, Jesus Christ, that was close. Dude, what are you doing, you maniac? What was that? Stupid horse. Like, why is the corner the best place to roll? There is, like, plenty of dirt all over here. In fact, we have a whole arena full of dirt. Dude, you're not going down there again. You have to go down further away. That's not smart. It's a good thing he doesn't really care about much. Oh, good decisions away from the corner. Oh, let's go roll right beside the fence. What a great idea. He literally will not roll anywhere but that corner, apparently.
which is stupid. Stupid horse. I tried to bring him over somewhere nicer, but he's like, nope, I know best. I'm a whole 2 years old. Child. I just wanted to show you guys how much he's lost the resource body. He's put on quite a bit of weight. If you look at the video when I first got him, you can see a big difference because he's a lot chunkier now. I wish I could leave his blanket off for him to just soak up the sun, but it's pretty windy, so I don't think it'd be very nice for him. He pooped on the blanket right before I took him out of the cross test day, which is super annoying. Right, Archibald? You're so annoying. I've been running Archibald just back to the pasture a few times. This is like the third time I've ever sat on it. And all three times have been bareback in a halter because he's a good boy. And we're gonna start like actually riding him like in a month or so. We just need to get his fitness up. And he's gonna be three at the beginning of March. So we're almost there. He is already broke though. This isn't like I do this with a completely unstarted horse. He did race twice. So he's less broke than 2 year olds who would have raced more, but he's still broke. I'd never do this with a horse that hadn't been broke before. Or she just has a pretty good brain. He just doesn't like circles and lunging, which sucks. But yeah, he's a pretty good boy. So he trotted in here. Being left alone really teaches them to come to the gate right away instead of making me wait. It's like, please take me. Milo has not been so good to lead the past week or so. He's been kind of weird. He's been more nervous and like acting like he's worried about people are gonna hit him, and because of that he's been more aggressive and on the defense. So I think there's a chance that someone has been messing with him a little and scared him, but we have cameras up now, so if that continues to happen, I don't really have anything to worry about because we'll catch it. But anyways, the chain is on him as a natural consequence if he tries anything stupid. So yeah, but either that or he's like, his attitude has changed because he's been feeding off my stress and my fear with some stuff that I've been dealing with. So it could completely be my fault, but either way, I just want to nip it in the bud so that he doesn't hurt anyone. I think I might lunge him and then maybe we can take him for a hack or something. I don't know. We're just going to do groundwork because he's been rude lately and untrusting and a bit unpredictable. So we'll try some groundwork. Although he seems better. Like, his mood's different today. Oh, you're so weird. And he seems less scared and stuff and worried. But the dynamic here has definitely changed in the last few days, so that could also be why. I think he's just highly sensitive, and any change in emotion or change in the atmosphere he's used to sets him off. There we go. You can roll after. Yes. So yeah, last time he was in here, he was being pretty disrespectful, and I didn't have him on a line. But he was crowding me. And as you can see, he's not doing that today, but he is also on a line. But if he does come in, he's going to get in trouble and he's going to have to work harder. That's okay, because he's just playing. He always just squeals like that. He hasn't been working in a few days either, so
it's kind of to be expected,
especially knowing him. But yeah, this is what we want. I want him out of my space. And see his inside ear, it pretty much exclusively stays on me. It only flicks away for a second. And he's not kicking towards me. It's kicking away. Ooh, which is, yeah, it's important to remember that he's a baby and still young. So like, working can be exciting after a few days off. But he's being respectful. He's not pulling me around. He's not coming in. He's not kicking at me. Okay, simmer. It's okay for him to play on the lunge line a bit in the beginning if he's had time off, so long as he doesn't come in or kick towards me or do anything that's disrespectful. Like, he has to stay in his own space, which he is actually surprisingly good at even when he's like this, because he stays right on the rail and he kicks away from me. Like, I mean, not everyone's okay with that, and I'm really not when he's in full work, but when he's had time off and it's cold, and since he's young, like when he's like 10, this is not gonna be okay.
But
this is kind of the horse he is, and if I ask him to
condense his feelings too much, he gets frustrated and he's just worse. So if he does it politely and rids himself of energy politely, that's okay. So we just start off and he can pick his pace at the beginning, and then I'm going to start asking him to do transitions. But this is a lot better than last time because he was coming into me, he came into me once. Okay. But again, his attitude's completely different. He's like Jekyll and Hyde sometimes. But he's very, very sensitive. That's one thing that people don't understand.
It's pretty frustrating sometimes. I'm still lunging him, but talking. Because people are asking me, like, oh, why aren't you jumping higher? Like, why aren't you doing this, that? Why is he so green? And it's like, I did start him as a three-year-old, but he wasn't asked to do much. And we've been really slow with what we're doing because of how he is. And what people need to realize about him is that he's special based off of how he started off life with all the neglect and the abuse. And he needs to have it taken slow, and he can actually, like, he could be dangerous if people pushed him or got mad at him too much or were too aggressive with him. It would completely ruin him and he'd become dangerous. Like, even I've seen how he can be with people who he doesn't know that discipline him, and it's not good. Like, they discipline him too roughly. Like, he's very, very smart. Usually yelling at him is enough to get your point across. But as I said, like, he's so connected with people and how they're feeling that his attitude changes depending on who he's with, how well he knows them, how they're feeling. So he's a very, very interesting and special horse for that. And I don't think I'll ever be able to sell him, not that I'd want to, just because it'd be very hard to place him with someone who would handle him appropriately and have trainers that would, based off of how horse people manage their horses on the average horse person. Like, most people wouldn't have him outside 24/7 on such a big field, and he'd hate that. I'm sure this is very boring just because he's going in circles. This is why you guys need to watch my vlogs with sound, because you can see his body language. Like, his inside ear pretty much exclusively stays on me. It'll flick here and there, but it flicks almost immediately back. So you can see he's focused on me. And he's licking and chewing. Being a good boy. Look at his freaking front end action. Oh, I love this horse. Another thing that I want to say that a lot of people don't think of is, like, a lot of people who own horses and like horses don't really have a concept of equine body language at all. Like, they think ears forward always means happy, which in some cases it does, but, like, they put their ears forward to listen what's ahead of them, right? So if they're flicked slightly back, it doesn't always mean that they're angry. Like, I've seen people comment and they're like, oh, your horse is so angry, and his ears are just, like, flicked back, listening to his rider or listening to something behind them. And then if their ears are forward when you're riding the entire time, a lot of the time, like, it'll mean they're not paying attention to you. They're paying attention to what's in front of them, which is why a lot of horses put their ears forward before a jump. And then ears pinned back obviously means angry, but some horses also pin their ears back when they're going over a fence or if they're running fast. Like, a lot of horses I breeze have their ears back when they're breezing, not because they're unhappy, but to avoid getting wind in their ears since they're going so fast. And I'd imagine that is quite unpleasant. But anyways, it's important to learn equine body language, because ears, like, flicked lightly back doesn't mean that they're, like, pissed off at you. Like, a lot of the time his ears are turned back when I'm riding because he's listening to me, because I talk to him quite a bit. And he also just does it even when I'm not talking because he's paying attention to me. But yeah, people need to learn that, because I think anytime they see the ears pointed somewhat back, people are like, oh, they must be annoyed. But it's like, their ears have such a big range of motion that they flick them back to listen to, like, anything around them rather than turning their head to do it. But yeah.
We're probably gonna go for a hack because I think he'd like that. And he's so cute.
Isn't he the cutest? The cutest bean? Okay. I think I might hack him, even if it's just around the property, because I want to do something. And I am kind of bored of arena work, and he probably is too, because that's all we've been doing pretty much all winter. Because the roads are too icy to go on. So let's do this, Milo. He's like, what? I'm not listening to you.
Never ride racehorses without gloves. I don't know if you can see that, because the sun's in my eyes, so I can't see. Oh, there we go. Isn't that gross? Lovely blister. I popped it today. And I have more that are on the way. I need to get gloves ASAP. Right, Bean?
We are
almost ready to go hacking, my friends. Almost. Hacking out is so important. It is so good for their brains. Especially if you can get them to hack out alone, it really helps with getting a braver horse.
He hasn't hacked out in a while though,
so I can't film for very long because there's a car coming. He's really good with cars though because no one ever freaking slows down here. So he's usually fine, but I mean, we had one really big scare where dogs came out of nowhere and like left at the fence right beside him, and he spooked and jumped right into the middle of the road. And yeah, so he left out in the middle of the road and we almost got hit by a car. It was very scary because people don't slow down or move over, so when horses do stuff like that, it's dangerous. So now I always walk him on the other side of the road by that property with the dog. But still, we gotta be careful. This is a quieter road though, so this one's a lot better. But yeah, he really likes going for hacks. It's a good change of pace because he was getting tired of arena work, and we haven't done this in months because of the ice, and I don't want him to spook and wipe out while we're hacking. I live in a really pretty place. There's mountains like everywhere, and my drive to work is beautiful, but obviously I can't film and drive. But yeah,
it's really nice.
Can't wait until both my boys can go hacking together and my mom can ride one of them, or someone else who's capable of riding Bebas. It'll be really nice for Archie, but I don't trust Milo enough off property right now to pony Archie without getting in an accident, especially going down the road that's a little busier with all the cars. I just don't trust it. Archie probably ponies well enough though, since he's off the track, but yeah, soon.
We might even bring Archie to a show in March to do flat classes. Think that would be good for him so that we can see how he is off property at a show situation, since that usually stresses race horses out, since it kind of mimics the track.
But yeah,
it's like, what the heck is that? I don't even know what he's looking at. Oh my goodness, what? I'm gonna turn around now and head back because the sun is setting. I also want to get home and like get some work done and hopefully have a nap. Look at the mountains. So pretty. I love where I live. Too bad it's so expensive that I'll probably never be a homeowner. Right, Milo? But at least I have you. That's a plus, right? I'd rather have Milo than own a house. Renting's not bad. We haven't gone very far, so this is like the world's shortest hack, but at least we did it. A good change of pace for the Bubba, but yeah, next time we gotta go further. He was awesome and very respectful today. He's getting little rubs from his shoulders for being clipped, but he doesn't like wearing his bra. Free the nipple, right, Milo? Even though you have none. Look at the mountains! I don't know if you can see them. My camera obviously doesn't make the view as good. This is just my water bottle. So he's like, what is this?
What? See? It's a bottle. Oh my gosh. Hey. It's a bottle. Oh my god, I was gonna drink that. Yeah, it's just a bottle, you silly goose. Come on.